What's up, CASA? I'm Yakota, and I'm one of your anchors for this week.
And I'm your other host, Michael. And you may have noticed that last week, we had Lizzie filling in for my position as because I was getting my wisdom teeth pulled. It was interesting, but I am back today.
Hi, my name is Michael Carson, and this is Sierra.
Let's get right into it after this video by Kyle Miller about what he's been up to.
It's been a minute, hasn't it? Let me show you what I've been up to. Weekly update. I've been producing some fantastic content for a channel known as 4Running Jake. I've been more intrigued by this sort of lifestyle content, especially outdoors things, at a time when there really isn't much else you can do unless you want to spread the virus and make everyone sad. So I've been really happy with this, producing content that I enjoy, and while everyone doesn't necessarily get to see it every week, it's something that makes me happy. So Casa Roble, remember, on a weekly basis, on a daily basis, to do things that makes you happy. And don't care what anybody else thinks. So, I'll leave you with some epic clips. I'm going to make a really thorough video. Oh no, why is there water coming out of the sky? The sky is crying. I cannot make video. I go inside now.
First off, let's go over some important dates for you to remember. On November 18th from 12:30 to 1:30 p.m. is an Interact Club meeting. For those who don't know, the Interact Club is a community service club affiliated with the Orangeville Rotary Club. It's not too late to join. The next important date is on November 20th. That's when term due progress reports are due. Make sure you get your grades up and turn in all your work. Let's check out this video made by yours truly before discussing some more important events.
What's going on, CASA? Today we're going to be diagnosing a few things going on with my car. So the main problem is when I go when I accelerate, my brake light comes on. And so we're going to look at that. There's a few things that it could be. And so we're going to go through and fix the things that it could be. One of the things that it could be is it's a sign of low brake level fluid. And sure enough, it is low. So let's go to the store and get some. Alright, so I just got out of the store, got my brake fluid that I needed. Make sure you want to get the brake fluid that is specific for your car. My car takes .3, some cars take .4 and some take .5. So yeah, let's head home and get this all done. Alright, so now we're here, we got the brake fluid, we're in my engine bay. I'm gonna take the cap off. Being careful not to get anything on it. And we're just gonna, oh, get a little. Fill it up about halfway-ish. Just because I don't have brand new brakes in, so it gives the chance for it to rise if it needs to. Alright, so that was that, and now I'm gonna go on a drive and make sure that I fixed it, and then that hopefully should be it.
Another important event worth taking note of is the Casa Roble PTSO meeting on December 1st. At 6 p.m. at the Action Day Learning Center located at 6822 Kenneth Avenue in Orangevale. There's also a virtual parent information night on December 2nd at 6 p.m. Hopefully more information on that will be released soon. Until then, check out this demonstration on the Veterans Day flag ceremony performed by our ROTC program.
Hi, I'm Senior Master Sergeant Scott Dawes. I am the Aerospace Science Instructor at CA 901 Casa Roble High School. So I was in the Air Force for 21 years. I went in 1996 out of high school and retired in 2017. Wow. So what was really interesting is when I grew up, my school didn't have an ROTC, but I learned about ROTC when I was active duty in the military, and I got to volunteer with a lot of ROTC units at my different bases. And then when I retired, it just seemed like a great fit.
My name is Cadet Lieutenant Colonel Drew Biondi, and I'm the Corps Commander for the CA 901st Casa Roble AFJ ROTC unit. Since I was a child, I kind of had this drive for military environments, and when I saw that something like that existed in a high school setting, I hopped on it and decided to take the opportunity that presented itself.
I am Lieutenant Colonel Kevin Hodak. I am currently the commander of the Junior ROTC unit over at Casa Roble High School. I was in the service for a little over 21 years, and I served my entire time in the United States Air Force. I could not have asked for a better career. I loved the entire time I was in the service, the different jobs that I had. I had a very fun career flying airplanes, so that was always a bonus, but just met so many nice people, and serving our country, I couldn't think of anything more honorable.
Today, this is Airman First Class Tony Galanti. I plan on going to either the Army or the Air Force for as a mechanic. What drew me to the ROTC program is when they came to my middle school and they did the rifle spinning and did like demonstration for what ROTC was kind of like. That just kind of drew me in, and it looked like a program that I would like to do.
We would also like to tell you about the 2021-2022 open enrollment lobby. This is essentially a process to request a transfer to a school or return to your neighborhood school following a transfer. Parents in the San Juan School District can enroll students into anyone's San Juan school under the condition that there's space available in the appropriate program.
For more information or for answers to any questions you might have, feel free to look at the bulletin that was sent out to you or your parents on Sunday. Alternatively, you can also dial 916-726-5826, go to www.sanjuan.edu/enrollment, or email enrollment@sanjuan.edu. But that's all for today, folks. Stay tuned every week for future updates. Bye, CASA.
Bye, CASA.